Can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So we will discuss excite the circle diagram of alternators, that is cylindrical rotor alternators. Now this is the voltage equation of an alternator, that is this EF, the open circuit voltage is equal to terminal voltage plus J IA ZS, where ZS is the synchronous impedance. Now this equation can be rearranged and can be written in this fashion. Here, that just I have missed the J will be there. So if we divide by J ZS, so this will be IA, this will be minus JVT by ZS, this will be VT by ZS, and this is EF by ZS. So if we take it on the, this side, that is EF by ZS minus VT by ZS is equal to IA. So if we draw the phasor diagram, then this is EF. EF. Now this is terminal voltage VT. So VT by IAZS. Sorry, this J will not be there because this is a phasor equation. So when I send the people material, I will just correct it. This is the equation we are drawing. So we have EF. So VT plus IAZS is equal to EF. So this is can be, and this is your IA. This is IA, and this angle is theta. This is IA and this angle is theta. Now, EF by ZS is a phasor which will lag EF by the impedance angle theta Z. So this is EF. So EF by ZS is a phasor, this one, lagging EF by angle theta Z. Similarly, VT by this is EF, so EF, and this is VT by ZS. VT by ZS is a phasor which is lagging VT by angle theta Z. This is VT by ZS. So minus VT by ZS is a phasor on this side, minus VT by ZS. So EF by ZS, that is EF by ZS plus minus VT by ZS should be IA. So this is IA. We already had drawn it. So this is EF by ZS. This is minus VT by ZS. Or if we draw in on this side, this is EF by ZS. This is minus VT by ZS. So this plus this is equal to IA. Now consider the machine is synchronized with the bus bar. Now we know that if it is synchronized with the bus bar, the terminal voltage VT is constant, and that theta Z is the impedance of the machine, which is substantially constant. So this, as long as VT is constant, VT by ZS, this magnitude is constant. This position of this phasor in magnitude and phase is constant with respect to VT. Now, what happens under this condition if we do not change the excitation? That is, if excitation remains constant, then your EF is constant, VT is constant. So EF by ZS, this phasor will remain fixed with respect to EF. Magnitude is constant. VT by ZS is also a constant phasor, lagging by theta Z. So what happens if the load is changed? Now, if the load is changed, obviously the current IA will change. Now, what will be the locus of the current? Now, this equation, whatever be the magnitude of current IA, this equation should hold good. That means, as if we have the machine excitation is fixed and it is synchronized with the bus bar, then as the load on the machine changes, then the current will change in such a fashion that its locus will lie on this circle. Because your Vt by Zs is constant, minus Vt by Zs, this is a constant phasor. And if EF is constant, EF by Zs is also a constant. So if EF by Zs plus minus Vt by Zs should be equal to IA, if this equation should be valid, that means IA, the tip of IA should lie on this circle. So basically, circle diagram, this circle diagram is called the excitation circle. So excitation circle, this is the excitation circle. Excitation circle is the locus of the armature current for a synchronized machine for constant excitation. Now what happens if we change the excitation? Now if EF is changed, then this circle diameter will change. That is, for EF1, if this is EF, this is the circle EF1 by ZS, then the current locus should be on this circle. So this angle is delta EF, between EF and VT is delta, and we have seen that for a stable maximum stability limit is 90 degrees. So in this triangle, this angle is a delta between Vt by Zs and EF by Zs. So that maximum value will be 90 degrees. So it maximum stability limit, it will can go up to this point. Beyond this, on this side, that will be unstable. So this is the circle, the excitation circle of a turbo generator. Now similarly, we can draw a power circle for a constant power. Now for power circle, actually that constant loss, the associated with the magnetic circuit and the rotating losses, that is not reflected in the equivalent circuit what we use, so that is not included, that is not shown in this figure. It is only for the corresponding to the electrical equivalent circuit. So P is equal to VTIA cos theta, this is the power output of the machine, plus IA square RA. So the other rotational loss portion, that also is included here. So for this equation, if we rearrange it, then your IA square, and divide by RA, then it is IA square plus VT by RA IA cos theta, and if we take P on this side, minus P by RA is equal to 0. So this IA square can be written as IA square cos square theta plus IA square sin square theta plus VT by RA IA cos theta minus P by RA is equal to 0. So if we replace by X is equal to IA sin theta and Y is equal to IA cos theta, then this represents the equation of a circle in the that is x square plus, we can replace x square plus y square plus vt by ra into y, vt by ra into y plus we add this vt by twice ra square is equal to p by ra plus vt by twice ra square. So this is equation of a circle whose radius is root over of this, that is root over of vt by twice ra square plus p by twice ra. So it's, this is p by ra, this will not and on this side the central center will be at 0 minus vt by twice ra. So this is again the locus of the current for constant power output. So the center is at, if this is our vt phasor, this is the origin of the vt phasor, then the center will be at 0 minus vt by twice ra. This is the center and this is the radius will be this quantity. So we will get a circle. So from here you can see that as p increases, the radius of the circle will increase. So we will have concentric circles. And for p is equal to 0, radius will be vt by twice ra. So this will be a circle which passes through O. This is the zero power circle. So if we now superimpose the excited, so this is also the locus of the armature current. So this power circle is the locus of the armature current for constant power, and excitation circle is the locus of the armature current for constant excitation. So if we superimpose these two circles, we will get the characteristic for the machine for particular excitation and for particular power output. Now, so this was our excitation circle, that is, this is EF, this is VT. So VT plus IZS is equal to EF. So this phasor is VT minus VT by ZS. So this is the center of the excitation circle, and with this EF by ZS we get this excitation circle for particular excitation. So excitation circles will be also concentric circles with center at point G. Now for the power circle, this lies, the center lies on this line, that is the voltage phasor line. So this was a point O, so the center will be here, 0 minus vt by twice ra, this will be the center. So for any particular power, say this is the circle diagram for this particular power p. So this excitation circle and power circle cuts here. So if your excitation is this, say ef, and power is p corresponding to this, then the current will be given by this value from 0 to this point. Now this same power circle cuts the excitation, this excitation circle for some other excitation at this point. So then that will be the current given by the for that particular excitation. So now what happens, the center of the power circle lies at a point 0 minus vt by twice ra. Now we know that for a synchronous machine ra is very small, so that means vt by twice ra is a quantity which is very large, and if we neglect ra compared to other parameters of the machine, that means vt by twice ra is infinitely large. So if we neglect ra, then this center of the power circle theoretically lies at infinity, and so our power circles will become power lines parallel to this horizontal line, parallel to this line. That is, if we consider the resistance of the armature resistance as a finite quantity, then the power circle, locus of the current for constant power is a circle. Now the center of the power circle lies at a point 0 minus Vt by twice Rn, and the radius of the power circle is given by root over of Vt by twice Ra square plus P by Ra square, P by Ra. Now, as Ra is small and Ra appears in the denominator, so radius is infinitely large if we neglect Ra, and the center lies at infinity. Then theoretically, the power circles becomes power line, constant power circles become constant power lines, which will be parallel to this line. This is a voltage phasor. So parallel, if this is the vertical axis, so that will be parallel to the horizontal axis. So what happens? That figure, that is the voltage so if now we will try to draw the operating characteristic. Now what is the operating characteristic? Now these are the excitation circles. These are excitation circle up to this. This is the stable operating. So this portion, these are the different excitation circles. So basically this point is this point, and as we have neglected the resistance, so this power circle is parallel to the excitation circle, we can make a horizontal line. Basically this then say now excitation circle is written as say 100%, 150%, 200%, 250%. That is as defined as if the excitation EF is equal to the rated voltage VT, it is defined as 100% excitation. So this is corresponding rated voltage VT. So this this distance is VT by ZS. So this is corresponding 150 VT into 1.5, and this is EF is equal to VT into 2, and so on. Now, this constant, when we want to find the operating chart, it is also called the safe operating area. Now, first thing what we will consider is the active power output. So the machine the machine has a MVA, that for synchronous machine on the nameplate, what is defined is the volt ampere rating. Now if we have a unity power factor, then volt ampere will be equal to the kilowatt. So that corresponding to active 100% active power, say this is the 100% power output. Now the machine is rated for some particular designed for some power factor. Say this is 0.9 power factor. So if the rated power factor is 0.9, now from here if we draw the line corresponding to the angle corresponding to 0.9 lagging power factor, then this line will cut the 100% active power line at this point. Now, if the machine is operating as a power factor which is lower than 0.9, then if we want to draw 100% active power from that, then the current will be current will exceed the rated current because the machine is rated for this power factor and particular current. So if we are drawing power at lower power factor, so the current will be given by a phasor from this point to this point. This is a active power line. So that current will be more than the rated current. So beyond this point, beyond that design power factor line, the power output, that output of the machine will be dictated by the current rating of the machine. So this is the corresponding to 100% active power. Then this is the this segment is a part of a circle which correspond to rated current, which center here. We draw a circle here. Now you see that the machine has a rated excitation also, because depending on that, what is the excitation value, the excitation system has to be designed. Say for this machine, if it is designed for 260% excitation, so 260% excitation circle is this one. Now this current, rated current circle, cuts the excitation circle at this point. Now beyond this point, if we try to draw rated current from the machine, then the excitation will exceed. So beyond this point, the output will be dictated by the excitation of the machine. And theoretically, as delta value is 90 degree maximum delta value, so we can go up to this point. So theoretically, from here, this one will be the operating area. But actually, we know that we cannot operate the machine with delta is equal to 90 degree, because the machine will be at the verge of instability. So what is done now? Say for a particular excitation, this one, say 100%, the maximum output what can be drawn from the machine is this one. So it is reduced by 10%, and then we draw a line parallel to the horizontal line. That line cuts the excitation circle here. So we will go up to this point, not beyond that. Similarly, for this excitation, this is the maximum power what can be delivered by the machine theoretically, but we reduce it by 10% and draw a line parallel to the horizontal. So it cuts the excitation circle here. So we get a point here. Similarly, for all the excitations, we reduce the maximum output by 10% and get the operating point. And if we draw or connect this operating point, we will get a line like this. So our operating chart or safe operating area is defined by this area, this shaded area. So the machine, when operating within this area, it will not exceed any of its rating. So this is called the operating chart of turbo alternator. Now I'll just repeat it. That is basically what we are discussing is the circle diagram of a turbo alternator. So first one is the excitation circle. So excitation circle is the locus of the armature current for constant excitation. Now here there is a mistake, that J will not be there. So basically EF is equal to VT plus IA ZS. So that equation can be rearranged as and written in the form IA is equal to EF by ZS minus VT by ZS. So if we draw VT plus IA ZS is equal to EF. Now VT by ZS is a phasor lagging VT by power factor angle theta z. Similarly, EF by ZS is a phasor lagging EF by power factor angle theta z. Now this is EF by ZS minus VT by ZS is equal to IA. Now if we draw on this side, this is minus VT by ZS. Now if the machine is synchronized with the bus bar, VT is constant, ZS is the parameter of the machine, that is constant. So VT by ZS is constant. So this distance VT by ZS is constant. And if we do not change the excitation, that means EF by ZS is also constant. So this is the EF by ZS phasor. So as the load changes, IA should lie on this circle. In that case, this equation will be valid, otherwise not. So for a constant excitation for a machine synchronized with the bus bar, the locus of the armature current is a circle with its center at point G, which is at a distance VT by ZS minus VT by ZS from this origin of this phasor. And for different excitation, we will have different circles with different diameters, but the center remains the same. So the excitation circles for different excitation will be concentric circles. So this excitation circle give the locus of the armature current for constant excitation. Now similarly, we can draw the locus of the armature current for constant power output. Now see constant power. Now this obviously we are considering only the electrical equivalent circuit portion, so that rotational and magnetic circuit losses cannot be reflected here. So that is included in this power actually. So this power is equal to VT plus IARA plus IA square RA is the loss, and this is the output of the generator. So this can be rearranged in this way, that is divide by RA, then IA square plus VT by RA, IA cos theta minus P by RA. So this can be written as IA can be written as IA square cos square theta, IA square sin square theta plus VT by RA, IA cos theta minus P by RA. So if X is equal to IA sin theta, Y is equal to IA cos theta, then X square plus Y square plus VT by RA Y minus P by RA is equal to 0. So X square plus Y square plus VT by RA Y plus VT by RA square equal to P by RA plus VT by twice RA square. So this is the equation of a circle with its center at a point 0 minus VT by twice RA and radius as VT by twice RA square plus this will be PA by RA. These two will not be there. So this is a again the locus is a circle. So power circle is the locus of the armature current. Obviously, it is synchronized with the bus bar for constant power. So power circles are also concentric circles because your center is fixed, but the diameter varies with power output. So power rating. So if the power output is zero, then diameter will be VT by twice RE. So the circle is passed through this point O, and for higher power, it will have larger diameter. So what will be the current for a particular power and particular excitation? That is obtainable if we superimpose that excitation circle and the power circle. Now, to superimpose that, this is VT, IAZS is equal to EF. So from this point O at a distance, VT by ZS lie the center of the excitation circle. So we will have concentric excitation circles like this. Now the power circle, the center lies on this line, that is on the voltage phasor line. And center is at a point 0 minus VT by twice RA. And for different values of power, we will have concentric power circles like this. So for this particular power corresponding to this particular power circle and for this particular excitation, the current will be this one, the intersection of these two circles. Now, the resistance of the synchronous machine is very small. So as the resistance is small, so basically VT by RA, VT by RA, that will be infinitely large. So the center of the excitation circle lies at infinity, and the radius of the excitation circle is infinity. So basically the power circle is infinity. So the as the resistance is small, if we neglect the resistance, the power circles become constant power line. Instead of concentric circles, we will have parallel lines. And we have neglected RA, so this distance VT by ZS will become VT by XS basically. And theta Z, which is the impedance angle, if we neglect RA, that is 90 degree. So basically, if this is the center of the excitation circle, this VT voltage phasor will be perpendicular to this. So this will be the voltage phasor line. This is the center of the excitation circle, and this is the maximum power up to which we can go. Beyond this point, on this side is the unstable region. So that is the maximum point. Now, when the machine is operating, we cannot exceed any of its rating. So what are the ratings given on the nameplate? MVA is given, voltage is given. So we have a particular current rating, then the machine is designed for a particular power factor. Otherwise, if it is operating at lower power factor, it will require more excitation. So, and also some excitation, it is designed for some excitation, because for different settings we require different excitation. So machine has to be designed for a particular excitation. So normally for generator, as for normal power factor is the load is lagging and it requires higher excitation for lagging load. So it is always designed for some values of excitation. Say for this case, the maximum excitation is 260%. Now, actually, the field system is designed for this voltage. Now, 100% excitation is when the excitation is equal to the rated voltage, that is EF is equal to VT. So for this value 260%, that means the field voltage is field excitation is such that the induced EMF is 2.6 into VT. So the field system has to be designed accordingly. Now, when we want to define the safe operating area of the machine, first one is the active power output. So as this is the voltage phasor line, so for unity power factor, current is superimposed here. So maximum power at unity power, what can be drawn from the machine is this one, corresponding to the VA rating which is given. Now the machine is designed for a particular power factor. So if this is the power factor line, this is 0.9 lagging, say. So if this is the power factor line and the 100% active power, this cuts at this point. So if we beyond this point, if we try to draw 100% active power from the machine, then the current rating will be exceeded. So beyond this point, the safe operating area zone is dictated by the current rating. In this zone, it is dictated by the power, active 100% active power. Beyond the power factor line, it is dictated by the current rating. Now, say the machine is maximum allowable excitation is 260%. So this is the excitation circle corresponding to 260% excitation. Now the current circle line cuts this excitation circle here. So beyond this point, if rated current is drawn, then excitation will be exceeded, required to be exceeded. So beyond this point, it is dictated by the excitation circle. And on this side, theoretically, we can go up to this point. So theoretically, this is the operating area. But we know that if we go up to delta is equal to 90 degree, then it will be unstable. The operation is unstable. So to avoid that, what is done? Say for a particular excitation, this is 100% excitation. This is the maximum power which can be drawn. Now that minus 10% is reduced by 10%. We draw a line corresponding to this, and this cuts the excitation circle here. So we get this point. Similarly here, this is the maximum possible power output, minus 10%. So if this line cuts here, so this way we get this point, and this is corresponding to that 10% rating. So corresponding to this, if we draw a circle, we get this point. So if we connect this point, we get a line like this. So we will, on this side, we will go up to this line, not beyond that, for safety. So our safe operating zone will be this one. This, then the current circle, then the excitation circle. Now, if we operate the machine within this range, none of the excitation will be exceeded. None of the ratings will be exceeded. So, and from the here, you can see that for any particular power, say this is the power, and if we know the excitation, the current will be given by the power line, and excitation line cuts here. And from here to here, we will get the current the machine is drawing. So this safe operating zone, it is called the operating chart of the turbo alternator. Now, similarly, we have drawn the circle diagram for the synchronous generator. Similarly, it can be drawn for the synchronous motor also. Now, the synchronous motor, if we replace IEA by minus IEA in the synchronous generator equation, we get the motor equation. So, here also that error is there, minus this J value. So, it will be EF is equal to VT minus IAZS. So, the equation becomes IA is equal to VT by ZS minus EF by ZS. Now, here if we draw the phasors, this is our VT. So, and this is EF. So, EF plus IAZS is VT. And this is IA. So, here VT by ZS is a phasor, lagging VT by impedance angle. EF by ZS is a phasor, lagging EF by impedance angle. So, this is VT by ZS minus EF by ZS. This will be IA. So, again, this is the, if EF is constant, then the locus of the current of the armature current should lie on this line so that this equation holds good. So the excitation circle for the synchronous motor are also concentric excitation circle, but here the center was on this side minus VT by ZS. Here at the point, VT by ZS on the right hand side. Now, similarly, we can get the power circle for the motor also. And this power equation for the motor will be like this, that is, in case of synchronous generator, the power was equal to the output power plus the losses. Machine was generating some power, so that minus the losses were the output. Now, for the motor, electrical power is the input power. So, this is VTIA cos theta is the input power, that minus the loss will be the output. Now, this is basically that includes the rotational losses also. So similarly, we can rearrange this equation. So it will be IA square minus VT by RA IA cos theta plus P by RA equal to 0. So IA square cos square theta plus IA square sin square theta minus VT by RA IA cos theta P by RA equal to 0. So similarly, we will have an equation like this, so that it is again the equation of a circle, only that the center lies at a point 0 VT by twice RA, and the radius is VT by twice RA square minus P by RA, it will be not twice RA. So if this is the voltage phasor, it is the 0 VT by twice RA, this point, and this is the circle for any particular power. So here you can see that as the power increases, the diameter of the circle will go on decreasing. When power is zero, if we have the largest power circle, this one passing through the point O, and for maximum power it will be just this point C. So for P is equal to 0, the radius of the power circle will be VT by twice RA. And for the maximum power, the radius of the power circle will be 0. Equating to that, we will get the P max value will be VT by, VT's, vt square by twice 4 ra. Now for maximum power, the power circle is a point C itself. So armature current vt by twice ra, that is here the armature current is from this point to any point on the power circle. So for maximum power, the power circle is a point C itself. The current will be OC is equal to VT by twice RA. So and the power factor is unity. So the maximum power, this is VT, power input will be VT IA cos theta. So VT into VT by twice RA into 1. So VT square by twice RA. So this is the power input for maximum power out. So, and this is the output power. So your efficiency at maximum power output condition is 50%. Now, in case of generator, we have superimposed the excitation and power circles and got the safe operating chart of the machine. Now here also we can superimpose these two circles to get the current for any particular voltage and for particular excitation and particular power output. Now here if we superimpose, we will have like this, that is this is our this is our excitation circles, different excitation circles. Now if the excitation circle, if what we have drawn here, this one, this is your VT, and this is the center at VT by ZS. So here, say this is VT. So at an angle theta Z, we have a line. This distance is VT by ZS. This is the center of the excitation circle. So this point as center with different excitation, we will have different excitation circles like this. And the for the power circle, the center lies on this voltage phasor at this point where this distance is VT by twice RA. So we will have circles, power circles for different power concentric like this. Now the maximum power circle, for the zero power circle, for zero power circle, the diameter of the, say this is the zero power circle. So for the zero power circle, the diameter is VT by RA. So here, say this is, and say this zero power circle passes this zero power circle, it passes through a point D here. Now say for this triangle, this is a right angle triangle because it lies on a half circle, so this angle is theta Z, because this line was drawn at an angle theta Z with the voltage phasor. So this component is VT cos theta Z. This diameter is VT by RA into cos theta Z. Means now cos theta Z is RA by ZS. So this is basically VT by ZS. So basically this point at which this zero power circle cuts this line is nothing but the center of the excitation circle. So zero power circle passes through the center of the excitation circle. And we will have now for a particular for the obviously there is a maximum value of excitation because this is a zero power circle. So for maximum value of excitation, that EF max, this excitation circle is basically tangential to this power circle. Similarly, for any particular power, say for consider these power circles, particular power circle, you can see this excitation circle is tangential on this side, and we have another excitation circle which is tangential on this side. So for this power, if the excitation is less than this value or greater than this value, we cannot have. So there is limit. So say for P is equal to 0, current IA is equal to OD. Now for zero excitation, current is IA is equal to, now for first consider the zero excitation circle. For zero excitation circle, it passes through this point and this point. So OD is the current, is equal to O dashed A in the, if we plot on this line, that is, this is corresponding to this point. Now for any other excitation, say corresponding to this one, this is for zero excitation, this is passing through the center of the excitation circle. So this is for zero excitation. So for, we are plotting basically armature current versus the field current or excitation. So for zero excitation, the current for zero power output is this one. Now for any other excitation, say this is the excitation circle, so corresponding to this power circle, we will have always, you can see that this excitation circle, we have two points. Actually the power circle is cut at two points, at this point and this point. So we will have two corresponding points. Similarly for this excitation circle, for this power circle, we have again it is cut at two points. So if this point, we have only one current, and for any other excitation, we always has two points. Now up to this, when we come to this point, this excitation circle passes through this point O, and on the this one passes through the point O. So for this particular excitation, here the current we also again has two points, but one is zero and one is some finite value. So we will have this point and some point here corresponding to this. Again, beyond that, again, it is cut at two points, say for this excitation. These are the two currents, this one and this one. So we will for all excitation circle, we have corresponding two armature current points, value of armature current. But at here, at this point, for the maximum excitation, it is tangential to the power circle. So we will have again one point. So if we consider the zero, so if we connect all the point, we will get a curve like this. This is called zero power. This is zero power, corresponding to zero power circle. Now consider some another power circle, this one, for another value of the power. Now for here, this excitation circle is tangential to the power circle. So below this excitation, we cannot draw this amount of power. So, and here it is tangential, so only one point. So corresponding to this excitation, we will have only one of value of armature current. For any other, for say next this one, this is cut at these two points. So we will have correspondingly two points corresponding to this excitation. Similarly, corresponding to this excitation, which passes through this point O, we will have for this, we are doing for this power circle, so we will have two currents, but this, or there will be a minimum value. Then beyond that, again we will have go on having currents by two values of current for each excitation, and up to this point, sorry for this one, up to this point. So corresponding to a particular excitation which is tangential to this, there will be one point. So again, for this P, we will again get a curve which have the similar shape, but it is smaller. So for all power, we will have curves like this. These curves are called O curves. Now, if you observe, it is basically armature current versus field excitation. Now we have drawn an armature current versus field current curve previously, what we defined as the V curve, developed from the phasor diagram. Now basically, if you look into it, you'll see that V curve is nothing but the lower portion of this O curve. Lower portion of the O curve, that is the V curve. Now actually, this upper portion is unstable region. Say for any particular particular value of power and particular excitation, for this we are having two currents, this one and this one. Now for this larger value, actually delta will be more than 90 degrees. So this is unstable. So all these point on upper portion, these are unstable point because delta is more than 90 degrees. So the stable point is only on this portion, and this is basically the lower portion. They basically is the V curve. Now for each and every one, we have maximum and minimum excitation. Now condition of maximum and minimum excitation. Now what is the, for figure G, the current OG is tangent to the power circuit, for which CG and the power factor will be minimum for that current. So this is a power circle. Now for the when the excitation circle is tangential to the power circle, like this, then the current is from this point to that point. So this is the current OG. So this is tangential. This is current OG is tangent to the power circle. And for this is the CG is the OG is tangential. CG is the power factor will be minimum for this power, and for here the power factor will be minimum. This will correspond to the minimum excitation. In second figure, this one, DF is drawn normal to OC. This is drawn normal to OC. When the excitation EF by ZS is equal to DO, then IA is equal to zero. This now here just for this actually this is minimum and maximum. What happens for this particular any particular power circle? Now the current this is the basically voltage phasor line. So the current. Now for the maximum value will be this I max from zero to this, and minimum will from zero to this is OF, and this is the maximum, and the so that can be shown from here. This is the center. The center actually lies on this line. So basically, the current. So for actually the for unity power factor condition, what happens? Unity power factor condition. The current will be along this line. So along this line. And so it will be, this is the maximum value and this is the minimum value of the current. So that so for both maximum and minimum, basically the power factor is unity. So if we this is the maximum current for any power, any particular power, and the this is the minimum value of the current, and here we will have the maximum on this side. So if we both minimum and maximum point, the power factor is unity. So we can the unity power factor line will be something like this. This maximum current value line, current, and if we connect, the unity power factor line will be along this line. So for synchronous motor, basically if we again we can have power circle and excitation circle. Excitation circle is the locus of the motor current for constant excitation, and power circle is the locus of the motor current for constant power. Now for motor, the excitation, if this is our VT, phasor VT, then the center of the excitation circle is at this point D, which is at a distance VT by ZS from this origin of this voltage phasor, and this angle is theta Z. So this is the center of the excitation circles. So center excitation circles will be concentric circles. So these are the excitation circle. And the, for the power circle, the center is at here, that is at VT by twice RA. And the radius reduces as the power rating increases. So this is the zero power circle. So the zero power circle cuts this line at say point D. So we have seen that this is basically, this is VT by RA. So this is theta Z. So this is VT by RA cos theta Z. So theta Z is equal to RA by ZS. So this is VT by ZS. So this is this zero power circle cuts this line at the center of the excitation circle. So it passes through the center of the excitation circle. So if we consider the zero power circle at this point, for that is for zero excitation, it passes through this point. So current is always given from this point O to this on the to a point of intersection of the power circle and excitation circle. So for zero excitation, this is the current, only one point. So zero excitation, this is the current, this point. Now for this excitation, it is this excitation circle is cut by the power circle at two points, this point and this point. So we have two values of current. So corresponding to this, we have two values of armature current IA. Similarly, corresponding to this excitation, we have two currents. So we have two points. This way, when we come here at this to a point, this excitation circle passes through the origin of this phasor. So one value of one current is zero, other is a positive value. So we have two points here also. So for all excitation, we will have two points. Now, when we come to this one, the maximum value of excitation, it is tangential to the power circle. So we will have one point here. So if we join all the points, we will get a curve like this. This curve is called O curve. This outer curve is for P is equal to 0. For any other value of P, say this one. Now, when the excitation is less than this, excitation circle, power circle does not cut, so there will be no operation. So this is the minimum value of excitation, and this point it is tangential, so we will have only one armature current. So corresponding this, we will have only one point. Then beyond this, say for this excitation, it is cut at two points. So we will have two points. Again, for the excitation which passes through this point, we have a zero and have a positive value. So we have a zero and a positive value. So similar, we have a curve which is similar to the previous one, but whose area is now smaller. So for different power, we will have curves like this. As the power increases, the area of the curve will go on decreasing. These curves are called O curves. Now basically, the lower portion of the O curve is nothing but the V curve, and the lower portion is the stable operating portion, because on the for this higher current, the load angle delta will become more than 90 degrees. You can look into this figure, this one, that is the angle between EF and VT. This angle is load angle delta. Okay. This angle is load angle delta. So if we go for this point to this point, this angle load angle delta. So we have on this this point on this side, the load angle is more than 90 degree. The EF by ZS phasor will be like this. So that is unstable. So all points on this upper side will be unstable. Only this lower portion is stable, and this that whole curve is the O curve. The stable portion of the O curve is nothing but the B curve, which is a plot between the armature current and field current. And for each value, we have a for minimum and maximum value of the current, the excitation is that power factor is unity. That is, for any particular power, say for this one, the minimum value of current is zero and the maximum is this one. For this, both these two, the power factor is unity. Now for this power circle, minimum current is this, maximum is this, power factor is unity. So if we join the minimum and maximum values of the current for different O curve, we will get a curve like this. This is the unity power factor line. This is on all points on this line, the power factor will be unity. And for every power, we can see that there is a minimum and maximum values of excitation, where the excitation circle is tangential to the power circle. For this circle, this is the minimum, this is the maximum. For this circle, this is the minimum, and maximum is not drawn. This one will be the maximum. And for the zero power circle, minimum is zero and maximum is this one. So we have two circle diagrams for synchronous motor and synchronous generator. One is excitation circle and one is power circle. Excitation circle is the locus of the armature current for constant excitation, and power circle is the locus of the armature current for constant power. For synchronous generator, superimposition of excitation circle and power circle gives the operating chart or safe operating zone of the machine. For synchronous motor, the superimposition of excitation circle and power circle gives the O curve. So I will stop here today. We will try to solve one or two problems on operating chart on the next class.